Good afternoon, everyone. I don't know how you follow the news, submarines and other things, so I'm going to do my best. I'll probably look pretty bland. I'm not going to put anybody under a wet balloon. I just have some maps, which are quite boring, but I think they're all recorded. So you like maps and leave calls to Newcastle for yourselves. As you say, Declan Murphy is my name. I have the good fortune of working on the Wildlands Away team and have done since the start. And the scary bit is I actually remember I was at the opening of the Geological Survey Ireland 25 years ago. I know I don't look that old, but I believe it or not, I am. So firstly, just to thank Tommy, Ronan, and Linda and everybody for the invite this afternoon to meet with you. I was just thinking on the way over, there probably isn't a better synergy than Wildlands Away and the work you do with Infomar. We're really, there's a great symbiotic relationship. And I was interested to see in Andreas's presentation that 69% of visitors they surveyed had heard of the Wildlands Away, which is quite good. We would like it to be higher, of course, but we're aiming for 100, but still 69 isn't too bad. So hopefully the technology works, as Louise said, never use videos, and I kind of said, sort of got out two videos, so what am I going to do? So hopefully it works. So again, I suppose, as we said in the intro, the Wildlands Away is quite young, really. Everybody probably, because they know, probably thinks it's around longer than it actually is. That's a picture of the launch with Minister Michael Ring. It was launched in February 2014, so it's just really 5 years old, which is quite new relative to a lot of tourism products. I'm sure a lot of you are familiar with it. Maybe hands up, how many people here live on the Wildlands Away or near it? Okay, that's good. That's over half, I guess. And so it's 2,500 kilometres. There's 188 discovery points, which many of you would have seen as the cart and steel sign there at the pull-in points. They're really photo points, we call them, where people come along and take a photo of themselves underneath it. And it has the name of where they are, so it becomes a kind of collectible. So there's 188 of those along the route. It's currently the world's longest tour route, coastal tour route, and the word coastal is important because Route 66 is just short of 4,000 kilometres, but again, that's not a coastal route as such. The route covers 9 counties, stretching from Kerry up to Donegal, all the counties in between. And I think it's fair to say when we launched the routine, it was going to be aimed just at overseas visitors. And then it was decided to include the domestic market. And why are we glad we did? Because I think the domestic market had taken to it so well. We weren't sure if they would kind of go with it or whether they think it would be something just for overseas. I suppose the rationale for the Wildlands Away is very straightforward for anybody of you living on it. I suppose back at that time, 2014, there was a huge kind of number of visitors primarily visiting the East Coast and Dublin in particular. And the West Coast as such, I suppose, was suffering in terms of visitor numbers. And I suppose as an island, we a lot of visitors want to see the coastal areas. It's very popular. And Andreas covered a lot of that in his survey. Now, this is like if you were in primary school, in my time we used to have to make nail pictures, which were little, you put nails into a thing and you had shred and you created an image. Again, giving away my age, anybody who probably under a certain age doesn't know what I'm talking about, but this isn't a nail picture. This is looking at the movement behavior of visitors, international visitors, and how they moved around Ireland. And I suppose the yellow thicker lines show the bigger, the wider the line, the more people. So you can see really it was Dublin, Galway, kind of Killarney, I guess, probably with the Cork and back up. But the green lines weren't spreading out into the coastal areas. So the whole rationale for why they went away was to bring those green lines out to the coastal areas. And I have a video at the end which kind of summarizes some of the figures, and that's on that one to kind of cover them twice. But so that's really, I suppose, in a nutshell, the rationale why it was developed, and it has been a huge success as well. Again, I'm sure everybody's familiar with the route. It's 2,500 kilometres, stretching off from Kinsale right up to Donegal, hugging the coastline where possible, where the roads permitted. Some of the route is not coach friendly because of the nature of the roads, just aren't suitable for it. But ideally, we're hoping that more FIT, including independent travellers, would avail of the route, smaller groups, maybe, you know, family groups and things like that. It's more conducive to that kind of visitor than the mess of the coach. Again, this is just an excerpt from a recent newspaper article, and I suppose really it does give an indication of how successful Wallentwe has been. Wallentwe has been shortlisted to win the title of the country's most influential project, and that's through the Project Management Institute of Ireland. Again, I think that kind of says a lot, as I say, 25-year-old project as such, and it has made a major impact. It has made a major impact in the towns and villages through which it passes. I suppose we always think our role is to create the route. It's almost like the shopping aisle in Tesco. We get the visitors going along the route, and it's up to the trade and the attractions and the accommodation to put out their stall and bring them in, so that we create the traffic, and then it's up to the businesses. And obviously, Ocean World do a really good job with 100,000 visitors. So, you know, that's where we see our role. Sorry, this is a video. So that just gives you an idea. That's obviously a consumer-orientated video that we produce, and we have a number of those, and they're different lengths, and I think they're pretty punchy, pretty vibrant. I think they would make you want to visit the Wildlands Way and encourage you in that direction. So again, I suppose our rationale is, you know, an intriguing convergence of land and sea, the longest defined coastal tour route in the world, 2,500 kilometres of magnificent Western Island coastline from the state of Cork to the Shannon Peninsula in County Donegal. And again, people often talk about the chevron or the logo we have. When we did a pilot actually originally, I think it was around 2013 or so, in Dingleland, there was all sorts of mixed reaction when people saw the logo. I think it sometimes means an avalanche, or I think maybe in skiing, but there's a lot of mixed reaction. But it can be anything you want. When I talk to students, it can be the symbol for the sea, the waves, or W-A-W is kind of included in it. So it's kind of a play on words, but it's now at a stage where, a bit like McDonald's, we don't have to put the name with the sign, people recognize the logo. And that's you're winning that at that stage. again, Andreas talked about figures there. I took down quite a number of them, particularly for the water basin, and actually I just got a copy of that survey. Well done, it's a great piece of work, and I hadn't seen it firsthand. I'm sure probably some of my colleagues have now in the other activity areas. But again, just where these are figures just purely for the wild Atlantic wave, where our visitors come from, and it was mention of Brexit there, but interesting to see not so many visitors saying that they're not going to come after that. So I think so. We've gone through shocks and things before, and you know, like the euro and the millennium and all these things were going to be around doing, and then it turned out that they weren't. So hopefully this is going to be something similar. I suppose we have to be optimistic. We just don't know what's going to happen, but you know, we have to be cautiously optimistic. Again, the EU, 1.8 billion visitors, the revenue is 679 and 990 from the UK, or sorry, USA, excuse me, 28%, UK, 980 as well, 28%, and others, 265. Actually, one growth area we're targeting very much is China. We've currently got about 100,000 Chinese visitors coming to Ireland. We're targeting to double that within 5 years. They're building an airport the size of Dublin Airport every month in China. They're the biggest outbound market in terms of numbers and, more importantly, spend. And so it's an area that we see a lot of kind of similarities. A lot of our music and dance, funny enough, is quite similar to what they have as traditional. And they like nature and a lot of the things we have to offer. So that's one of the new and developing markets that we'll be targeting more. We're running courses presently for the trade on how to target the Chinese market, because there are idiosyncrasies, like every culture has different needs and wants, and cultural differences in that. So we're running courses to inform the trade, the tourism trade, on how best to manage Chinese visitors so that their stay is as comfortable and as welcoming as possible. Again, I suppose the reason we're here, and from the National Tourism Development Authority, from the government point of view, is really a number of things. And you know, Andreas mentioned about jobs, 240,000 jobs. But again, it's building a world-class industry and product, better regional spread of visitors and season extension. It's actually fantastic that you were here in Dingle in October. I think it's maybe over 100 delegates or so. That's a fantastic injection at this time of year to deal with. So I applaud you on that, and I'm delighted that you're here. Hopefully all your other conferences will be along the Wild Atlantic Way as well in future years. Caroline, who's coming up after, will know we have developed a new system, and Caroline actually works on some of them as well in a professional capacity. Visitor experience development plans, or destination plans as we're calling them, where we're targeting certain areas and trying to amplify up the good points of that area, or the advantages. I suppose in a lot of counties they have similar things they can do, but in certain areas you can possibly do them better than other areas. They might have a natural advantage. And I suppose we're doing a visitor experience development plan presently in Dingle, for the whole Dingle Peninsula. We've done them on the Skelly Coast and Three Heads, and looking at things like culture and timeless well-being and that, so that we're looking at experiences that will be conducive to that. And obviously the sea and water sports are going to feature very strongly in that, because it's a very core aspect of the Wild Atlantic Way. So the desire with that really is that visitors will understand what's on offer and what's unique about Dingle, and hopefully then visit for those reasons. Again, it's primarily aimed at the FIT market, individuals and families and that, and with an end game of season extension, and also of getting visitors right around the peninsula. There is issues with congestion, which we're looking at addressing, and we're presently looking at developing a remedy or a plan for that. And so that, again, is trying to spread visitors to all the areas, and every area benefits, not just the habit. So again, I'm just going to go through these quickly. Really, the objective is motivate visitors to stay longer, spend more, reduce seasonality, increase slow travel. That isn't that people suddenly start walking at half the pace they normally do, but that they're not running around And, you know, we reckon it takes about 9 or 10 days through the wildlife to go away as a visitor. That's stopping, having your coffee, going to our attractions, having a nice lunch. That is when I had a group from Port Ireland bring me and ask me how quickly can we do the wildlife down to Grey House, and I never want to know the answer to that question, because that isn't really what we want. It's not, we want people to do it slowly. Sustain and increase jobs, vibrant coastal communities, similar to yourselves, prosperous enterprises, engage stakeholders, protect the special environmental, cultural, and linguistic character of Wildlife Quay. We're in a greater tier as well, and there's other areas as well, in Connemara and Donegal, so that it's important to preserve that and build it in as part of the offering because it makes us unique. Now, the funny coloured map is the dark blue line on the coast, and the west coast is Wildlife Quay. The lighter blue shading is the Wildlife Quay region, which is an area that feeds off it. Then the green and brown there is Ireland's hidden heartlands. The yellow is Ireland's ancient east. Purple is Dublin, and then you have the Northern Ireland offering. But when we market Ireland abroad through Tourism Ireland, we sell the whole island of Ireland. It was one of the first dividends of the Good Friday Agreement. And that's why it's so important that it stays in place and isn't disrupted in any way. So again, there are programs. I'm sure you've probably seen TV advertising for different programs, as we call them, or newspaper advertising, so that every part of the country is included in a program. There's a lot of white spaces where somebody isn't included in their marketing programs. So I suppose how we operate, we sell Ireland first and foremost, and then within that, one of the four programs, if that makes sense. Again, that's just the cover of the trafficking of visitor experience development plan, which hopefully will be active now from January, February time. We're just finishing off aspects of it. Again, when Tommy and Roland and Linda were in touch with me, I think some of the ideas, just the kind of opportunities that we could look at, and some were suggested by Tommy, you know, in terms of the maritime treaty visual components of the Wild Atlantic Way, highlight the dramatic seabed topography heritage that extends offshore, help promote water-based Wild Atlantic Way activities, highlight coastal marine routes, tourist features, and I know you have Dr. Connie Keller coming later speaking about diving over X. Show networks of coastal services, SMEs, infrastructure, slips, and piers. This is really, really good for us because it's supposed to be kind of looking from the land and using the sea for water sports and activities, and we have 26 islands on the Wild Atlantic Way. But since we don't have the expertise, we're kind of tourism people, not necessarily well versed on the expertise that you have. So we're actually having our Wild Atlantic Way team meeting here in this hotel actually next Monday, and I'm going to bring that up as something that we can work more closely with you and to maybe talk to you about how best to do that, what opportunities there are for partnering on different projects and things like that. So I think my next slide is a video, and it just summarizes some of the things, so I think I'm just about right on time.